So we're just reached the midpoint in the session of the 2015 legislative session, and this is where the House and Senate bills will flip over sides. And so far at this point, there's been several bills dealing with efforts to try and help strengthen our neighborhoods and address some of the problems that folks have brought to me when knocking on their door in our community. There's been a lot of controversy surrounding the issue of education this year, and I think that's unfortunate. You know, I think that we should be focused on how do we make sure that teachers have the resources that they need to be successful. How do we attract and retain the best and brightest teachers? What can we do to make sure we keep college affordable? And you know, and what do we need to do to help our struggling schools in our community succeed? And unfortunately, this session's been a lot about finger pointing between the State Board of Ed and the superintendent, and a lot of things that get lost in that are the conversations we need to be having about real pragmatic things we can do to try and help improve our system of education. Continuing to streamline the process of homes that are stuck in the tax sale process, abandoned homes that have been left behind and no one's paying taxes. How do we make sure we get those back into the market, in the hands of people who want to buy them and fix them up? What are the right incentives? We're looking at offering a tax break for people that buy an abandoned house and fix it up as their own, a break on their property taxes. And we think that'll be helpful to try and address this problem, and hopefully we'll make some progress this year. The first is a pilot program to help targeted neighborhoods across the state get added resources to hire public safety folks, code enforcement, a variety of different things to try and tackle the problem. Here in Indianapolis, there's 6 hotspot neighborhoods that have been identified. One of them's on the west side in our district. And I think these resources will be a benefit. And then the other is how do we crack down on people who have committed a crime with a gun? You know, how do we make sure that people that are using guns to commit crimes in our community, make sure that they know that they're going to be prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law? So one big one right now is House Bill 1003, which is going to establish a blue ribbon commission for the legislature to look at how do we improve the system of redistricting, of redrawing the district maps in our state, so that politicians aren't picking the voters get to pick the politician. And we want to look at how do we make sure that districts aren't drawn to where people have no competition, they never get run against, and make sure people have a real choice when they go to the ballot box.